Hey guys, how's everyone doing? So I just finished watching the first episode of Boku Dake ga Inai Machi, or Erased, and it was absolutely amazing. I absolutely loved this first episode of this anime. It was just excellent, honestly. I don't even know how to describe it. It was everything that I expected it to be. I haven't read the manga, but this first episode really drew me into it. I was paying so much attention to this episode while I was watching it because it was just so interesting, and I love that. I love when a first episode really draws you in, because then you want to keep on watching, you want to know more, and that's exactly what happened with Boku Dake ga Inai Machi. So I absolutely enjoyed it. Before I go on, I just want to say that this is probably gonna have like little minor spoilers. It's not really too much. I mean, this is the first episode, but just in case you guys wanted to go into this anime completely blind, you might not want to watch this video, so I'm just saying that ahead of time. The episode begins with our main character Fujinuma, and he's telling us how he's afraid of, you know, himself, knowing his own mind. And that in itself is really interesting. I was like, why does he feel that way? So he's a struggling manga artist. He doesn't really have the material to provide to, you know, manga magazines, and they don't really like him too much. He's a guy who doesn't really laugh or smile a lot. He just seems kind of like, eh, all the time, you know? Like, he just doesn't look happy. You know what I mean? It's just that kind of aura that he has around him. He doesn't seem happy. He actually works at a pizza shop. He delivers pizza, and there's another girl there. Her name is Airi, and she is weird to him. He thinks that she's so weird because all she says is like the same thing all the time, and he doesn't think that she likes him like that or anything. But one day he's out making a delivery on his little moped thing, and he passes this boy, you know, this kindergartner, and he's just there on the sidewalk holding his little flag because he wants to cross the street. And Fujinuma drives past him and keeps on driving, and then all of a sudden it's like a premonition happens, and he's like, what is this? I can't describe it as anything else besides a premonition or like deja vu. He's like, this happens to me several times. It's called a revival. And basically he goes back in time like 1 to 5 minutes before an incident has happened, and he has to find out what is the odd thing in that situation. So he noticed that a driver on the other side of the road who was driving a truck was actually going to hit that little boy who is going to cross the street. So he has to go turn around from the side of the road that he's on. He does like a U-turn and has to stop that truck driver. So let me just say that he successfully stops that truck driver, and that little boy is saved. But in turn, he ends up in the hospital. When he wakes up, Airi, his co-worker, is actually there with him, and she's talking with him and told him what happened to the little boy and what happened to the actual truck driver. This is where we learn more about his revivals and how he has had them before, and how they really don't end up with anything beneficial out of them. You know, he doesn't get anything out of these revivals. He's always involved in those situations, but he never gets anything good out of them. I mean, now he's in the hospital. He saved that little boy, but now he's in the hospital. So that's pretty interesting to see how he can revive and go back in time just a couple of minutes and just totally stop a horrible, horrible, devastating situation. Very, very cool, very interesting, and I really like the whole concept. Eventually, he goes home, and his mother is actually visiting. She has like really big lips, and it was just kind of funny. That's not the point. She seems kind of indifferent to him. She doesn't seem like she really cares about him too much. She's like, oh, I'm just here traveling from, you know, Hokkaido and whatnot. And you don't really have that sense that she's really there for him all the time, but maybe she is. We don't really know too much about her because this is only the first episode, obviously. But, you know, she takes over his house, his bed, his TV, everything, and she kind of claims it for herself, and it's just relaxing and whatever. And one day they both go outside, and Fujinuma has one of his revivals, and he's like, there's something out of place here, but he can't tell what it is. So he asks his mom, like, don't you feel something weird? And she's like, oh, you know, you have asked me that before. And she looks around, and you kind of don't know what he senses is wrong, but she pays attention to this one guy who's like holding this little girl's hand walking towards like this van type of car, and she ends up taking a picture and everything, you know, of the license plate or the car and whatnot. But then she starts talking about an incident that happened in the fifth grade. It turns out two kids went missing. Here's the thing, back in fifth grade, Fujinuma used to hang out with this guy. It's an older guy. They used to, you know, play around, you know, fly paper airplanes and stuff like that. That guy is named Yuki, and he was known for having courage. And you really see, like, this guy is like the older brother type. You know, he's playing with Fujinuma and stuff like that. And he kind of looks up to this Yuki character. But here's the thing, when Fujinuma was actually in fifth grade, two classmates were actually kidnapped and murdered. And who was the prime suspect? Who went to jail? Yuki. And right there, when they revealed that, when they said that, my heart like sank. I was scared. I was surprised. And I didn't even know what to do. I was like, oh no. And I was like, wow. But was this guy really the culprit? So Fujinuma's mom ends up investigating for herself, and she starts going through, you know, newspapers and looking through that incident that happened in 1988. So she goes through newspapers, through books, through everything, and she really discovers something huge. She's like, this guy, the guy who they accused of kidnapping and killing those two children, he was not even the guy, it was someone else. And she ends up kind of knowing who it was, and she gets so close to telling her son. But unfortunately, that night, the night that she finally discovers everything and is about to tell her son, she knows too much and someone comes in and kills her. So she ends up dying because she's stabbed, she bleeds out, and that's the end of her. She doesn't tell her son the truth. And unfortunately, when Fujinuma comes back home, he is basically framed as the murderer. Because when he discovers her, he ends up touching her body and he gets blood on his hands. And now he is seen as the murderer because his neighbor or whatever she is came to his house to deliver a casserole. So now they think that he killed his mom and whatever. He's trying to run from the police, and all of a sudden he goes through a revival again. But this time there's something a little bit different. He ends up going all the way back to 1988. So he doesn't just have a revival that was from the previous 1 to 5 minutes. He ends up going all the way back in time to fifth grade, and now he is back in that time before his classmate is kidnapped and killed. So it was just so much information in one episode, so much going on, so complicated, so crazy, so creepy, and it was just perfect. Overall, the first episode of Boku Dake ga Inai Machi was absolutely wonderful, and that makes it sound nice and sweet, but it's not nice and sweet. This anime feels scary. It has so much mystery to it, and I just want to uncover the truth. Like, I'm so curious, like, what exactly happened when he was in the fifth grade? Who actually kidnapped those children? Who did that? Who is the real murderer? You know, I'm just so curious, and I want to know more, and I can't wait until next week. It feels like so long. So I was pretty shocked with what happened to his mother, especially because I didn't expect that to happen. I read the synopsis of this anime and I saw that someone does die, but I didn't expect it to be his mother. So I was really shocked and surprised. We just got introduced to her in this episode and she seemed kind of indifferent, but you know, she was too close to unraveling the whole truth and knowing everything and telling her son the truth about what happened in fifth grade, because she finally understood. She finally, you know, discovered the real truth behind it. And once she got too close to that, it was like, you know, it's just very sad, you know, to see her go so fast. But, you know, at the same time, now it just made me more curious to know the truth. So yeah, just a really solid first episode. This is probably my favorite debut of the winter season so far. I haven't watched everything yet, so I was really happy with ERASED or Boku Dake ga Inai Machi. If you would like to watch this anime, it's on Crunchyroll right now. Please watch it. Do yourself a favor and watch this anime. It's really, really awesome, and I can't wait to see what this anime holds in store for us. I want to see. I want to know the truth already. You know, it's so unfair. You have to wait. Thanks for watching this video. I totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, subscribe if you liked this video, and I'll see you guys next time.